Hello all you wonderful people. My name is Anansha Alamyan and it's very hard to balance so many books on one hand. Welcome back to my channel where I talk about books, productivity and writing tips, especially on Medium. Today's video is a little different from the ones I usually make. Today I'm going to talk about some books which used to be absolute favorites when I was growing up. So basically I was cleaning my bookshelves and I came across some books which used to be childhood favorites. I got them stacked up right here to show them to you. So I'm going to talk about some of the books which I used to love while growing up, and then I'll tell you what they are about and how much I remember them and how they shaped my journey as a reader. So if you are a beginner or a reader who wants to get back into reading and you're looking for suggestions that are not very difficult, this might be the right video for you. So let's get started. I cannot make any talking about my childhood as a reader video without mentioning Harry Potter. This is the 6th edition, which is actually my least favorite of the series. But anyway, anybody who knows me knows what a Potterhead I am, and Harry Potter books were the reason why I got started as a reader. I initially started my reading journey with Enid Blyton, but then I discovered Harry Potter because of my friend Stuti. I have already talked about my journey with Harry Potter in another video. I'm going to link it right here. The Harry Potter, if you don't know, it's about a boy, 11-year-old boy, who receives a letter under very strange circumstances from a strange person in a strange school who tells him that Harry is a wizard. And Harry doesn't know this. He has lived all his life being the sad boy who nobody loves, and suddenly he discovers this amazing new world where he can do magic and he has friends and people actually care about him. So this was the reason I got introduced to reading, more or less, and I'll be forever thankful to this book for that. The next is a book by Alistair MacLean. It's called Breakheart Pass. Well, actually this is a book that I inherited from my father because it's a thriller. Alistair MacLean writes amazing thrillers, and I don't actually remember what this book was about, but if you look at the cover, you can see that there is a gun and there are some bullets. So obviously this was a very serious story. Anyway, my favorite book by Alistair MacLean was The Golden Gate, and that was an amazing story. I had never read too many thrillers when I was 11, 12 years old. Then Alistair MacLean was actually my first introduction into the world of thrillers, and I was shocked at how amazing they could be. And these books are especially more dear to me because they belong to my father. He used to read them when he was in college, and he has actually written his name here. My father used to study at RAC Calicut, and you can see the date. It says 9381. That's like 1981, more than 10 years before I was born. And it's just a wonderful feeling to hold something in my hands that my father had in his college days, and it must have shaped his youth. And I am so lucky to have inherited such books. I wish I could like them more. This reminds me, maybe I should start reading them again. The next is Animorphs. If you are not familiar with Animorphs, this is the story of 6 children who suddenly discover a huge mind-blowing secret that the Earth is under invasion by some strange mind-controlling aliens called Yurks. So this is actually pretty dark. To be honest, I don't know how I survived through this book. So Yurks basically are slugs. They are mind-controlling slugs. They enter through your ear and they take control over your brain. So you have your own body, you have your own conscience, but your own consciousness is trapped inside your head and you have no free will. Your body is going to obey whatever the Yurk is going to say. You can't speak of your own mind. You can't do anything you wish to do. You have to follow whatever the Yurk tells you to do. And to be honest, that's some pretty dark stuff for a child to be reading. Also, these children, these Animorphs, to combat the Yurks, there is another group of aliens from a different planet. Those are called Andalites. And they have the power to absorb the DNA of whatever living creature they touch, and they can turn into that living creature. So since our heroes, they live on earth, they can turn into whatever animal they touch. So you can see the cover has a illustration of a girl turning into an animal. It's an anteater. And then the pretty cool thing about this book was that when you turn this page, there is the same animal, this anteater, and it's eating a bunch of smaller aliens. I told you, this was pretty dark stuff. Another cool thing about this book is that at the bottom of each page, there was an animal. And if you flipped the pages real fast, you could see this person turning into an animal. See, I'll just show it to you again. Isn't that cool? I was fascinated as a child, and there are, I think, 54 books in this series. I haven't read all of them, but I used to have a huge crush on a character here. His name was Marco. He is a Spanish guy and he has a very tragic past, but I used to love him for his sense of humor, and you could say that he was my first ever bookish crush. The next, which I'm sure every 90s kid from India can relate to, Goosebumps by R.L. Stein. And this was a special edition. It was called Give Yourself Goosebumps. Now, people who have watched Netflix and who have watched Black Mirror and their latest episode Bandersnatch, you might be aware of the concept where you can choose your own ending according to the options that you choose. So this book was pretty much the same. Oh, and also I discovered a scale which I must have used as a bookmark. Memories. Anyway, so this book has choices. So when you read something and then at the end of the page, there will be some choice, and then you have to pick that choice, and then you can turn to that page. Let me just show you one example. So you see here, there are two choices at the end of the page, and then depending on which option you want to select, that you have to turn to that page, and you can see this one has an ending. So each book has like 11, 12, 13 different endings, and only one or two of them are happy endings, and the rest are where you get killed or eaten in the most gruesome way possible. So Goosebumps was basically horror slash science fiction. So it was mostly about ghosts, shapeshifters, or weird ass aliens who came to Earth with the only intention of killing and kidnapping human beings. But yeah, they made for amazing reads. Another book that I absolutely loved as a child was Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy by Douglas Adams. This book is science fiction but comedy. So it's sci-fi comedy, and it's one of the most brilliant books I have read in my life. Like, trust me, I have read 750 plus books, but this still remains one of my favorites. Douglas Adams is a genius with words. He can write sentences where you will actually laugh out loud. I remember I was reading it in a family function. There was a family function going on, and I was sitting with a bunch of cousins. Everybody was doing their own thing. I was reading this book and I was laughing out loud at certain scenes. And my cousins were like, tell me what's going on. And I actually couldn't tell them because the jokes out of context might not be so funny, right? But yeah, Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy begins with a bang, a literal bang, where the entire planet Earth is destroyed, completely annihilated. And then after that, the adventures begin of our protagonist Arthur, who is a human being who lives in London, if I remember correctly, and his best friend Ford Prefect. So it's a series of 5 books. As a child, I enjoyed the first 3 books because they were superb and funny and very hilarious. But I did not quite like book 4 and book 5 in the series because I thought it was very boring. That's the word I use, boring. But recently, like in 2020, in the earlier part of 2020, I decided to reread the entire Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy series. And this time around, I loved the books even more than I liked them when I was a child. And I could appreciate the beauty in the 4th and 5th books, which I thought were boring. They were actually very deeply philosophical, dealing with issues of existentialism and taking a very deep look into human psychology and the imposter syndrome. the plot was actually more layered than I had imagined as a child. So yeah, right now if you ask me which is my favorite book in the entire series, it would be book 5, Mostly Harmless. It remains one of the best books I have read. Last but not the least, I used to read a lot of Sydney Sheldon's Animals and Moons. Currently, I don't have too many here right now with me, but this is one book that I loved a lot as a child, and I am actually embarrassed to admit it, but I used to love cheesy love stories, cheesy romance as a child or a teenager. This one is called My First Love by Callie West, and as you can see from the cover, the only story in this book is a boy and girl flirting, and they have some obstacles, and towards the end they live happily ever after. These are the books which gave me unrealistic expectations from a relationship when I was a child, and I still blame them. So yeah, these are the 5 books that I used to read as a child, and I have read many times over and over again, even today. I hope you enjoyed this video. It was a light video, a fun video. So let me know your thoughts in the comments below, and please, please, please don't forget to mention what are the books that you used to love as a child. I would love to know your taste and how it evolved with time. So yes, that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, don't forget to like, share with your friends, subscribe, and hit the bell icon. Bye! Keep reading and stay awesome!